It must be ThinkPad season, because look at what I found at the thrift store, including its original battery, power supply, docking base, and even the key to lock the docking base. It's a ThinkPad X series. It's an X61. There's the price I paid. I actually got it about a week ago, but it's been sitting since I've had other things I wanted to get videos of in the meantime. Centrino Pro, which means it has a probably Core 2 Duo and Intel graphics and Intel wireless. Designed for Windows XP, but of course you can put almost anything on these. This one even has the fingerprint reader. Screen's kind of dirty. Keyboard's a little bit worn out, but not too bad. About the same as my X60. I already did a video about these X60 and X61 ThinkPads. It's called Still Amazing After 10 Years, so if you want a full review of these computers, watch that video, so I won't go into too much detail on this one. So, it's a pretty standard X61. Does have the FireWire port there. Of course, the docking station adds an optical drive. Doesn't say what it is, so I don't know if it's a DVD ROM or DVD burner or even just a CD drive. But of course, I can swap this out for anything I want. There, it still has the 56K fax modem. There's the key to lock it, as I mentioned. And it even has the ThinkPad logo on the keys. Isn't that cool? Docking base adds serial and parallel ports. Unfortunately, no PS2 ports on this model. I think it was the first generation that the docking base no longer offered them. Looking on the bottom of the laptop, it was originally property of SNG. I have no idea what that is. It has a Windows XP professional product key. There's quite a bit of dust in that air intake, so this may need to have the fan cleaned and re-lubricated, just like my T61. Speaking of which, now that I have both of them, I can show you the size difference. On the left is the T61, on the right is the X61. And there they are stacked on top of each other. The T61 is quite a bit wider. But the X61, including its battery, is just about as deep as the T61 without its battery, which sticks out this much more in the back. And there you can see the difference in thickness. I applied power and the battery light is flashing orange, which is probably not a good sign, but if the battery turns out to be unsalvageable, I have a spare one for my X60 which I could put on this if I need to, so it's not too big a deal. At the store, I did turn it on and get into the BIOS setup, so I know it has at least some signs of life, so I'll turn it on here. Press the ThinkVantage button so we can get into setup. Alright, F1 for setup. BIOS version 2.22, I'll need to look that up, see if that's the newest version. Of course, I could put the Middleton BIOS on this, but probably only do that if I put an SSD in this thing. CPU is an Intel Core 2 Duo T7300 at 2 GHz, which is quite a bit faster than the 1.66 GHz CPU in my X60. 3 gigs of RAM, could be upgraded to 4 gigs. Startup, let me just make sure the boot order is correct. Yep, recognizes a Hitachi hard drive, so should be good to go. And there we go, Windows XP. Wonder if it's the original installation. Huh, that's interesting. Somebody was putting their own little artwork on the Windows background. Trackpoint is working. Taking quite a while to load up. But who knows when the last time this thing was started. MOL. I have no idea what that means. Volume goes up to 25. On mine, it only goes up to like 14 on my X60. That's interesting. Yeah, it goes all the way up to 25. They must have changed that. I don't know if this is a newer driver or something different with the X61. Versus the X60. Old virus definition file. More than 30 days old. Has malware bytes on it. Excel 2007. Adobe Reader 11. Windows Update on the desktop for some reason. Windows Media Player. My Bluetooth places. ThinkVantage Productivity, which is the original software this came with. PowerPoint 2007, Roxio Digital, Digital Media Plus, Word 2007. Somebody put calculator and notepad on the desktop. QuickTime Player, Outlook 2007, Irfan View, and something called Lahasa. A whole bunch of things in the system tray here. LightScribe, Bluetooth is in the system tray, but the light is not lit up, probably because it's not connected to anything. Install Shield Update Manager. A Semantic Antivirus, don't know how old that is. A program from 2000, I don't think so. Oh, here it is, virus definition file, June 21st, 2013. So, obviously hasn't been updated in quite a while. Maybe their subscription expired and they never renewed it. Intel Graphics Media Accelerator says registered to authorized MOL user of MOL America Incorporated. I have no idea what kind of company that is. Apparently something international, judging by this background they put on there. Computer name is XXXYYYZZZ SN type part number. So obviously nobody ever filled that out as belonging to the work group. So nobody ever changed that either. Somebody put Google Chrome on this. Wonder what version that is. Wireless networks detected. There's RU Bookstore and RU Courses on it. So obviously it belonged to some kind of Rutgers student. I'm not going to go snooping much more than that. Just want to see what version this is. Version 35. The battery's at 0%. The battery had, what does that say? A battery error has occurred. Yeah, go away, I don't want that. Can I get some kind of status window on this? Here it says, the battery has failed due to normal wear. The battery cannot be charged. Replace the battery. 90 watt AC adapter is attached. So I guess the battery is no good. I don't know if there's any kind of way to rejuvenate these things. It has an 80 gig hard drive, which is 3/4 full. Probably the original hard drive, I would guess. So it's all working. No obvious signs of any malware infection so far. They did have malware bytes installed, so they must have at least kept up on that. Downloads folder is empty. Probably cleaned this whole thing out when they got rid of it. My pictures, nothing in there. So they cleaned out everything, looks like. Whoever owned this. Although the recent documents folder is fully populated, I'm not going to show you all the file names there in case it has personal information. Somebody put Power Toys for Windows XP on this. Software 995. Something called PDF Edit 995. Never heard of that. And it's opening up Google Chrome for some reason. WinZip. Wonder if they actually registered it. It's licensed to MLO America. Has a registration code and everything. So somebody actually paid for WinZip. And the favorites are full as well. I see DCH Brunswick Toyota. So somebody who owned this must have owned a Toyota. So pretty well-used Windows XP laptop here. Everything seems to be working. One thing that maybe some of you already noticed is that what I thought was an optical drive in this docking base is actually just an empty plastic frame, which apparently was made by Mitsubishi. That's kind of interesting. But I upgraded my ThinkPad T61 with a DVD burner so I can take its CDRW DVD-ROM drive and put it in here. And that works just fine. And if you need one of these drives, they're dirt cheap and very easy to find. I got that DVD burner for my T61 for $6.60, including shipping on eBay. And if anybody needs this thing, just let me know, and it's yours. I don't have any use for it. So except for the battery, I got a fully working ThinkPad X61, including the docking base and even the keys, for $40. And I don't think that's too bad of a deal.